Hi, I'm Ellie. I started Ellie Craft Co. about 4 years ago when I started learning cross stitch, and then quickly grew bored of it, started knitting and crocheting. But when that was when I was overseas for studies. When I came back to Singapore, of course, we don't need all this crochet or knitted scarf anymore and cardigans. That's when I got interested in dressmaking. But as you know, dressmaking, you need a sewing machine. I can't sew on the go. That's when I became interested in hand embroidery. What got me interested in needlework is actually that rhythmic, that just when you sew, you have to be in that space where you cannot think about any other things. Or it's almost like meditation, like where you just focus on one stitch after another. And the more you sew, it is very therapeutic to me, especially after a long work day. It just calms your mind, calms your soul, and after you focus on each stitch, perfecting each one, and then the end product is actually something that is very different from that individual stitch. So what it taught me was also that every stitch was very important. You have to do it well. You don't actually notice it when you're doing each stitch, but when you look at it at the end of it, that it can be very different and it can be beautiful as well. When friends became more interested, they asked me to hold workshops, and as well as they were interested in getting what I was embroidering. That thought was actually quite scary to start a business since I already had a full-time job. But I thought, why not just give it a go? What's the worst it can be, right? So I just started an Instagram account, a Facebook account, got some admin matters settled, and that's how it grew from 4 years back till now. What I enjoy most about holding workshops is actually to meet other people and also to share these skills and knowledge with everyone. Oftentimes, when I see my students enjoy themselves during the workshops, and looking at them at their sense of accomplishment at able to finish a project, that also gives me that fulfillment in knowing that I've imparted something to someone, and then that's their journey to take with their hand sewing journey. I do get a whole age range for my workshops, which is why I enjoy teaching so much. So my youngest is as young as 4 years old, and actually my oldest participant is actually a group of 80-90 year old ladies who have been sewing all their lives. I teach something called sashiko as well, and it was something new to them. So what really impressed me was that at their age, they never stopped learning. That although their eyesight might not be the best, they make do, they find ways to compensate for them, so they could have, they always sit beside the window so that it's bright. Some of them have a magnifier when they sew, it's quite cute to see. But they persist on, and that's because their love for sewing is so great. And it's something that also keeps them company. They have a group of close friends who sew together as well. Some of the fears that my students face is actually to make mistakes or actually to perfect every single stitch. So what they see is what I have sewn, and of course that is after through many, many years and many, many hours of practice and sewing already. When students come for my workshops, it's usually their first time sewing or hand embroidery, and I say, just go ahead, make that mistake. It's your first one. It won't look nice now, but as long as you keep practicing, as long as you keep perfecting each stitch, making sure that you have the right foundation and the right technique, you can never go wrong or too far badly with that. In this day and age where everyone is multitasking, every one of us is multi-hyphenated, it is actually very hard to take time to slow down. So for me as well, it's actually very intentional to actually block out blocks of time to do nothing. And by doing nothing, it can be to just read, or a lot of times for me it's to sew. Without that space to calm down and think, I might just be going in a circle and round and round. But with that time and space to reflect, to slow down, I'm able to find deeper purpose for each of the tasks that I'm involved in. And then that helps to find deeper meaning in what I'm involved. Embroidery brings me peace. Because when I sew, it's usually at night when there's no distraction, where it's just me and my sewing project. And it allows me to just slow down, reflect on the day, as well as find my rhythm again for the next day. So in the next video, I'll show you some basic stitches that you can learn and pick up along the way, and we'll create various different small projects together.